G'day guys, Dean from Blog for the Blood God here, and on today's episode I wanted to do something slightly different than what we've done in previous episodes, and instead of just talking about the different Legion traits and stratagems and combos, I want to actually put some models on the table and show you guys some very specific things that you can do with the units in the Chaos Space Marine Codex to maximize the benefits and the utility that you get out of those units. So today we're picking the Chaos Rhino, and I'm going to show you some different ways that you can use this to not only get maximum utility out of that Rhino, but to also further enhance the abilities that the other units in your army will have. So without further ado, let's get into this Chaos Rhino Masterclass.
Log for the Blood God.
All right, let's start by quickly going through the armies that we're going to be using for this demonstration. So on one side, we have the World Eaters. We have a couple of Rhinos, a couple of units of Khorne Berserkers led by Khan the Betrayer himself. Then on the other side, we have Blood Angels. We have a Chaplain, we have a big unit of Vanguard Veterans, and we have a unit of Sanguinary Guard. Now, the reason that I've chosen these is because this is something that most people would intuitively say is a favorable matchup for the Blood Angels. The Blood Angels have the speed, the Blood Angels have the durability, and the Blood Angels are not lacking in any of the damage output, so that gives them a significant advantage over the World Eaters. However, what I want to show you is how including these two Rhinos in the list actually gives the World Eaters a significant advantage. Even though it doesn't give them the same amount of movement, it doesn't give them the same amount of durability, what it does give you is access to some very specific techniques and tricks that you can use to really boost up those World Eaters. So with that being said, let's get into the first example of how you can use Rhinos to make your World Eaters very, very powerful. Now, before we do, it's just worth saying that this trick that I'm about to show you is relatively universal. It's not exclusive to World Eaters, and it's not exclusively useful against Blood Angels. These are just a couple of armies that I have on site that are gonna be a perfect illustration of how this technique works. All right, we're gonna start with a relatively typical deployment. So the Blood Angels player has deployed all of their units 12 inches from the center, which pretty much regardless of which mission you're playing, that's as close as you can possibly get to your opponent. Then the World Eaters player, knowing that the Blood Angels have a 12-inch move characteristic, a 12-inch charge, but they get a +2 movement from the Chaplain, the World Eaters player deploys 26 inches away from the Blood Angels. And what you're doing there is you're guaranteeing that if they get the first turn, they are not able to charge you. Now, given that we've got a central objective, let's say the Blood Angels player gets first. Even though he's not going to be able to charge you, he's still going to want to push up the table and control the center. So let's say the Blood Angels player moves his units up their 18 inches. Oh, sorry, there are 16 inches, something like that. Moves his Chaplain up into the middle and moves the Vanguard Veterans along this way as well. So we've now got Blood Angels coming at us right in the center of the table. Now, the typical problem that you're gonna face in this sort of setup is that when those Blood Angels, when those Berserkers now disembark and fight, you're gonna wanna hit both units. However, if you do that, one of them is going to spend command points to interrupt the attack sequence, and they're gonna strike your unit before it strikes. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna show you how you can use the Rhinos to prevent that from being a real problem. So, the first thing we're gonna do, the Blood Angels have done their turn. Now, what we're gonna do is we're gonna disembark out our Khorne Berserkers. They're 9 inches, right? So they're pretty much directly in front of the Blood Angels here. So we've got a unit of Berserkers here. Let's say Khan jumps out this way with his unit of Berserkers as well. So all of these units have disembarked out within 9 inches, because you get the 3-inch disembark move, plus you get an additional 6 inches for your movement characteristic, and they've moved out like so. Now, if you were to just go, cool, I'm gonna slide them across a little bit and them across a little bit. So if you were to just go, cool, these Berserkers are gonna charge the Sanguinary Guard, these Berserkers are gonna charge the Vanguard Veterans, what's gonna happen is you're gonna fight first with one and probably kill the unit, but then your opponent is gonna spend command points, they're gonna interrupt, The Sanguinary Guard are going to kill those Berserkers. Then it's going to go into your opponent's turn, and those Sanguinary Guard are still alive, and they're going to charge and kill these Berserkers, and then it's game over. So if you don't do anything, you're in a very tricky spot. However, what you can do to prevent this from being a problem is move your Rhinos in. They're 12 inches as well. That one there, and that one there. All right? Now, in your charge phase, you're going to charge with this Rhino first into the Sanguinary Guard. He rolls a 10 for his charge, and he's basically going to side slam in to these three Sanguinary Guard here. So they're all now in base contact. Then this Rhino is going to do the same thing. So he's going to roll his charge, he rolls a 5, and he's going to slam right into these three here. Right? So now you've got these three in base contact and those three. So when you charge your Berserkers in, doing this unit first, you can then place your Berserkers in such a way that as many of them are within engagement range of this front Sanguinary Guard as possible without being in range of any others, right? So you probably do something like that and these back two aren't going to get to fit. Then you do this unit and you do the exact same thing. So you put as many into this gap as possible. Maybe this Rhino had to move across a little bit, which we saw he had plenty of movement to be able to do. And you just go in, right? And Khan, he can just sit back and observe the carnage. No, pun intended. Now, basically what's going to happen is you now look at the situation and you go, okay, if you fight here first, these Berserkers are going to likely kill most if not all of this Vanguard veteran unit, right? Because you're going to be able to pile in and you're going to be able to get a ton of them in through these gaps and you're going to be able to fight with pretty much your whole unit of Berserkers and just wipe all that out. Then, when your opponent goes to interrupt, if he interrupts with this Sanguinary Guard unit, these three models can't actually move because they're touching that Rhino, which means when he goes to do his pile-ins, this guy can move his 3 inches, having to end closer to him, and he is more than 4 inches from this Sanguard at the front. So even if he moves that way, he's not going to end within an inch because he only gets a 3-inch move. So his pile-in will go there. These guys will all have to end up closer to that. And basically, you've just forced your opponent, when they interrupt, to use all of these guys to hit a Rhino, which means only one Sanguinary Guard is going to strike those Berserkers. So let's say you do it in that sequence, and basically this guy piles through into this gap here, this guy piles in there, this guy piles in to fill this gap here, this guy piles in over here, and then this guy goes in there. You're probably not going to get to strike with the whole unit, but you're going to get to strike with a whole lot of it. Probably three guys won't get to strike. So now what you do is you use your stratagems like Veterans of the Long War, Stoke the Nails, all of the various World Eater stratagems that are often quite cheap, only 1 CP, and you use that to ensure that when this unit strikes, even though only 7 out of 10 made it into combat, those 7 are going to comfortably kill all of these Vanguard, right? Which is not unrealistic. Khorne Berserkers are very, very brutal. You can get them up to strength 7 AP 4 with +1 to wound, so you're going to be wounding on 2s, and you're going to be ignoring their saves, more or less. Very brutal, so you've killed them. Now, your opponent spends their command points to CP interrupt. Now, if they do it with this guy, he's only going to be able to attack the unit of Khorne Berserkers that just fought, because they've piled into him, and they've already fought. So he can't now pile in over there. So he's not likely to do that because there's no benefit because that guy can't die and he's going to get to fight anyway. But if they use the CP to interrupt over here, yeah, they're probably going to kill your Rhino, but all of these attacks have to go into the Rhino, which means one guy gets to attack your Berserkers. Let's say he goes crazy and kills 2, right? You just remove the 2 that wouldn't have been able to fight otherwise. And now those 8 that remain are all going to be able to make their attacks into that Sanguinary Guard unit, which means you're likely to kill most, if not all of them. Let's say you don't kill all of them, say you kill 5 of them, just because that's how many fit in my hand. Now, you've done all your attacks, you've killed both units more or less, you go into your opponent's turn, and he now has to deal with 2 entire units of Khorne Berserkers with three Sanguinary Guard and a character, which is not likely to do it. So he's likely to just go all three into that unit, that character, all into this unit, and finish it off. That's the one that they killed two out of before. So they finish that off, which leaves you with this unit of 10 here. And then in your turn, they then go in, attack, fight first, and just kill both. And now it's game over. So even though the Blood Angels have more movement, they have more attacks, they have better attacks with upgraded weapons, they can fly, they have better armor saves, they have better profile all round, they get plus one to wound when they charge, they have better just everything. The very fact that you're able to bring Rhinos in your list gives you a significant advantage in that matchup. And it's worth noting that neither the Sanguinary Guard nor the Vanguard veterans go inside Rhinos. So this is a really important way that World Eaters players or any combat-based army can use Rhinos to make it so that when your opponent wants to interrupt you, they get minimal value. Alrighty, for this next example, I want to show you how to use a single Rhino to get absolute maximum speed for one of your units. So let's say you've got a Rhino here, he's got 10 Khorne Berserkers inside, and then you've got two units of five back here, and your opponent has the same eight Sanguinary Guard, the same Chaplain, but then he's got five Intercessors back here holding his backfield objective. Now, you've got three objectives here. Basically, you want to control the center and yours. They want to control the center and theirs. So let's see what happens. Once again, let's give the Blood Angels the advantage
going first. So they're going to do the same thing. They're going to move up their 4 inches, right? No, they're 14 inches, sorry. Now, when they do so, you're going to be able to use this Rhino to slingshot one of these Khorne Berserker units into that assault, into that Intercessor unit, even though they're across the other side of the table. So basically what's going to happen is the first thing you're going to do is measure one of those Berserker units 9 inches, right? So that's their 9-inch mark. Then what you're going to do in your movement phase is you're going to disembark out your 10 Khorne Berserkers, and they're going to go in and they're going to munch on some Sanguinary Guard skulls, right? So they're going to disembark out their 9 inches like so, and they're going to go for that big charge and attack the Sanguinary Guard. Right, now this is obviously a huge advantage. So imagine that your opponent's got the rest of their army over there. They've got all kinds of other units, right? Now, this is where the trick comes. Now that this Rhino is empty, what you can do is move that Rhino so that the back of the Rhino ends within that range, right? So he's got a 12-inch move, so you can easily fit him somewhere like this, right? Now, what you can do is move this Berserker unit with an advance of 4 inches, so a 10-inch move total, which gets the unit to here, which ends entirely within 3 inches, so they can now embark in the Rhino. Then this unit makes their charge into the Sanguinary Guard, touching as many as you can so that you get as much utility out of your combat as you can, right? Now, this Rhino is going to make its charge, and it's gonna roll a 7, which is a pretty standard charge, right? He's gonna move 7 inches, and the important thing here is not to touch that model. Don't get in base-to-base contact with it, just end within engagement range. Now, when you fight with your Khorne Berserkers. Now let's hypothetically say that you wipe that entire unit of Sanguinary Guard, right? So they are now all dead, removed from the table. But because your Rhino declared a charge this turn, it is eligible to fight. Now, most people would just dismiss this. Why bother fighting? However, what a fight actually gives you is a 3-inch pile-in move, an attack, and a 3-inch consolidate, as long as all of those end closer to the closest enemy model. So this Chaplain will be our closest model, so we have to end closer to him, but we essentially get to go, cool, we're going to pile in 3 inches, like so. And now we're going to fight, we don't get to make any attacks, and then we're going to consolidate a further 3 inches, right? Now it's our opponent's turn. Let's say this guy goes in and he goes, ah, cool, I kill a bunch of Berserkers, cool, right? Let's say he goes absolutely crazy and kills that many, it doesn't really matter. Now it's your turn, and you're going to be able to disembark the 5 Berserkers that hopped inside that Rhino last turn. You're going to be able to disembark them out their 9 inches, to here. And then you're going to be able to roll your charge, which you roll a 6, which is going to fail. So you're going to command point that charge into a 10-inch charge, which gets you in. And now your 5 berserkers, in 2 turns, have actually traveled from where they were back there, 46 inches in 2 turns. So a unit that normally only has a 6-inch move characteristic is able to get a 46-inch move in 2 turns. And the reason that this is few reasons. One, because that Rhino didn't actually move in a movement phase whilst holding any berserkers. It was here, it disembarked, then whilst it was empty, it moved. Units embarked in it, it charged, then in the next movement phase, you disembarked. So you actually didn't use a movement phase with anything inside that Rhino, but through a combination of the extra 3 inches that you gain from embarking, the 6 inches of the Rhino, another 3 inches that you gain from disembarking, plus the charge move from the Rhino, plus the 3 inches of the pile-in, and the 3 inches of the consolidate, all of that is free movement that you're gaining on that other unit of Khorne Berserkers. So being able to use an empty Rhino as a slingshot to throw berserkers across the table means that your opponent's sitting back here with his intercessors thinking, yep, they're safe. They're going to get a round of shooting into those Khorne Berserkers. And little do they know that you've been using that Rhino to slingshot your units forward to massive effect. Alrighty guys, I hope you enjoyed that video. If you did, make sure to like, subscribe, and comment, all that good shit. Let me know if this is the sort of content that you would like to see me do on a more continual basis. You can also show your support by signing up to my Patreon, which is only $1 a month, 25 cents a week, costs fuck all, and it's going to encourage and incentivize me to do more of this content, and it's also going to let you have direct access to me where you can request specific content. And if you request it on the Patreon, I'll do my best to make sure that all of those requests are met. So make sure you head over to my Patreon and show your support there. And yeah, I'll see you in the next one. Thanks, guys. See ya.
Walk for the Blood God.
Do your objective markers ever get lost behind terrain or other models and become difficult to see? Do they ever get bumped and accidentally moved during a game? And do they ever spark arguments about distances? Well, not anymore. Introducing the Blog for the Blood God, not even remotely patented, neoprene objective markers. Made from the same material as astronaut suits, or maybe military equipment, or probably neither of those things, this 2mm thick neoprene synthetic rubber is tear resistant, water resistant, and is designed to last. But that's not all. The Blog for the Blood God, not even remotely patented, neoprene objective markers come in a variety of different designs and styles to suit any faction represented in the Warhammer 40,000 universe. These objective markers are a perfect gift for yourself or a friend, and are a perfect way to flex and show your opponent that not only are you a smarter, cooler, and better 40k player than them, but you also have more disposable income than they do. For the low price of $25, you'll get not one, not two, but 6 neoprene objective markers, perfectly designed for 9th edition Warhammer 40k. But wait, there's more. For a limited time only, people who sign up on Patreon to support Blog for the Blood God as a Skull Champion tier, $5 per month member, will gain access to a custom design service where I will design a unique logo to support their gaming club, like the one I did to the left here for the Potato Farmers local gaming club here in Melbourne. Follow the links in the description of this video to pick up your set today.